Alright, kinda not really doing something different today. I'm doing stuff I've done before, but I'm going into the woods, like my last video where I was creek fishing. Fishing a different section of the creek, which is not really a creek, it's actually part of an irrigation system from back in the old mission days, called the Asakea. But I just call it a creek because that's a lot easier to say, a lot quicker to say. And a couple months ago, me and Jake were out here walking through the woods trying to find some, not necessarily abandoned, but some graves that we found, that I had found years ago in the middle of the woods along the creek. And we couldn't find them. Now, I mean, everything's still green, but it's officially winter and all the plants are starting to die down. It should be a little bit easier to get in there and walk around. Maybe I'll be able to find them today. Don't usually like doing this stuff on my own, but I need to get a video out. It's about 52 degrees and it's rainy, so I've got my waterproof gear on for the GoPros. So the audio today is gonna be a little, it's probably gonna be pretty crappy. You might not understand what I'm saying. So for the most part, I might have music playing over it. I might have to do some narration when I get home during the editing. We'll see what happens. Last time when me and Jake were out here, we couldn't find what we were looking for because we came up to a section that was impassable. There was a bunch of downed trees, we just couldn't get through it. And I'm thinking that when we changed direction there, we turned and went around. I think it was in there somewhere. And that's what I'm looking for today. I'm gonna try to find that spot that we couldn't get through. And I'm gonna try to get through it. So. Right here, I come up to the creek and throw out my first cast for the first time. Didn't get any bites right here, so it was kind of pointless. This part really threw me off because I don't remember there being a fork in the trail when me and Jake were there. So I think this could have been what really threw us off when we were looking for it, because I remember walking this direction and there's a drainage pipe under the trail here, and straight ahead there's a downed tree that was blocking the path, and I remember all that. But back over there where the fork is, none of that was there. There's a whole bunch of trees there and we couldn't get through, and now it's been completely cleared, it's been mowed and everything. So at this point I decided to stay to the left side and move on, because we didn't check that part out. Thank you. right here. I'm coming up to a bend in the trail, and the creek bends there too. So right there, there's pretty much a 90 degree angle, a corner. And when I walk up to it, there's a lot of plants that are usually a good sign for fish. There's always fish in these plants. They're called elephant ears or something. So I decided to start throwing out a couple of little casts here. The water's also deeper right here in this corner too. And there's a lot of mosquitoes around for some reason. But right here, really looked like a really good spot. In this part here, I'm swatting the mosquitoes away and everything, not paying attention. And I get a bite. I finally get my first bite, and it pulls hard and it runs off. But I wasn't able to set the hook because I wasn't paying attention, and I missed it there. Right here, just as I'm getting ready to cast out, you see I start pointing at something, and there's a big snapping turtle that just came up right into that corner there. There's a lot of water runoff from all the rain lately that's draining in right there, and the turtle went up in there and then turned around and went back towards the left. And then immediately after that, on my next cast, somewhere around here, I see a fish, or I get a bite and I bring it up to the surface, and the fish is still on there, but it slips off. So I actually saw the fish, and it was just a small bass, probably 8 inches, but that was still pretty good. And it always happens when I'm swatting the mosquitoes away. There it goes right there, I think. Nope, whenever I reel it in, you'll see it. Well, you might not see it, but... that was it right there. I had pulled one in, I started pulling it in, but it slipped off the hook. I actually stopped right there for a little while. I was throwing a couple of casts. Real shallow water, but I thought I saw something moving around. It ended up just being a turtle. And then when I turned around to walk off, you see right here, I got really excited when I found this. I thought it was one of the gravestones I was looking for. I ended up uncovering it as much as I could, but it was actually not a gravestone, but it was a big, kind of an L-shaped piece of concrete with a groove cut through it. So it could have been part of a wall to something, or a foundation, or a floor. But it was right there where the gravesites should be, and I was checking everywhere to see if that was it, but it was pretty disappointing. I'm starting to think maybe it's been relocated, because if you look, there's like an old telephone pole that's been dug up right there. All this extra earth. It's been piled here, like from bulldozers and stuff, just covered in leaves. It's been a while. You see that there? Whole bunch of seashells and stuff that I've noticed. So maybe they dredged it out from the creek. If they did all that, they could have easily relocated what I'm looking for. And this stuff here and piles of stuff over here in the ground, it looks like it's had stuff pushed over there, like from a bulldozer and stuff, all the debris and stuff over there. So if from what I remember, when I first found them, they would have been right here in this area. And there's an uprooted tree. It's been cleared. It's been cleared for a while because everything's starting to grow back. But I think they were right here and they've been relocated. I've also been seeing a handful of these wooden planks here, about a foot wide, inch thick. I've seen a couple of them, flip them over, nothing underneath them. They're all broken off. There's some that are sticking up out of the water back up this way. I'm gonna flip this one over right now. And there's a real cool looking spider right here. Not sure what kind of spider that is. Wolf spider, maybe. It's big. Look, there's another set of these planks I was just talking about. They're sticking up out of the water. There's a bigger one there and then a smaller one next to it that's broken off. I don't know what those are. There's another plank there sticking up out of the water. And these are man cut. These are they're cut. They're not natural. Piece of concrete. Oh, that's like a something buried here in the ground that's concrete. But I'm imagining it's whatever that stuff is over there. Some kind of concrete blocks or some planks there. Yeah, that's what it is. It's this stuff. They're all busted up, and there's some of those wooden planks all around the concrete stuff here. No idea what that stuff is, but it's got probably a 3-inch diameter hole, like a series of 3-inch diameter holes all through it. Kind of like a honeycomb, I would imagine. Here's a little section here that's clearly been bulldozed at one point. You can see where they dug in right here, squared, and then pushed up all the dirt over there up against those trees. So, I don't know what they were doing with these little, it's probably a bobcat, about the size of a bobcat bulldozer. I know they're not bulldozers, but I'm saying that so people don't know what I'm talking about. There's more of that concrete stuff back there. So they were doing some kind of work out here. It's been a while. A couple of months, because there's all kinds of stuff growing over that now. Right here, I spot something just off. It was actually on, there's a little bit of an incline right there, I guess, piled up dirt. And I spot this silver box on the other side of it, so I come over here to see what it is. And I pull it out, flip it over. Just trying to make out what it is. I couldn't figure out what it was. It had metal feet on the bottom of it there. I thought maybe it was a computer tower or something. But it had clasps on the case, like a suitcase would have. Like a briefcase, but it was all metal. And I flip it over, and there's toggle switches. There's two towards the left side of it there, and then one on the right side towards the bottom. And it says motor, one says light, and then the other one says sound. And it took me a while to figure it out. When I flip it over, finally, there's a part where I scratch off to see what it is. And it turns out it's a projector. An old, very, very old projector, like a movie projector. And it's got the place in there for the film reels and everything. But I ended up leaving it there. I probably should have taken it with me. It was pretty cool. It actually still had the light bulb in it, which is really unusual, because I mean, usually the light bulbs are the first things to go. They usually break or disappear. And you can kind of see the light bulb towards the left side down there. Right there where I was pointing was the reels for the film. And right now I'm reaching down and touching the light bulb on it. And that's the sound switch right there. Yeah, it's just a very, very old film projector. I don't know where it came from or what. Right there, I'm scratching it off, and I read it. See, I thought it might have been a projector just because it had the light bulb on there. I get my pliers out, and I scratch off the plate and read it. And I forget exactly what it says. It's some kind of projector. If I haven't explained it yet, or if you haven't seen the other video when we were out here looking for it, what I'm doing is trying to find something that I originally found when I was about 11 or 12 years old. When I was 11, 12 years old, I used to ride bikes everywhere, all through the bike trails along the river, through the woods here, because you can see there's a mowed path through the woods here. We'd run through here on the bikes, and eventually, probably another half a mile, three quarters of a mile, it would run back into the main bike trail along the river. And it follows this little creek over here, the irrigation channel. And one day when I was 11, 12 years old, we're coming through here, and right in the middle of the trail, next to a big tree, similar to this. Well, first we saw in the tree there was a white cross, and it was probably about 10 feet up in the air, and it was a reflective material, so you could see it from further away. Like if you shine a light on it, you'd be able to see it from far. And right next to that tree in the middle of the trail were three graves. They had names, they had dates and everything on them. One of them was buried there, I think, in the 20s. One was buried there in the 50s. One was buried there in 1992. I specifically remember seeing 1992 because I thought it was weird that it would be so recent. I mean, when I found this thing, it was probably 97, 99, somewhere in those years, before I even went into high school. Hell, I could have been in elementary school. It's probably around 1997 when I found them. So that means they'd been there for about 5 years, that one had. It had been buried there within the last decade, which is really recent for something just out in the middle of the woods like that, you know? And it's not part of the cemetery. It's part of the park, the river. I remember the last name on there. The last name was Richardson or something like that. That was it. I found them when I was 11, 12 years old. And then when I was a high school senior, you know, we're always doing stupid stuff. We went walking through here again. And I found them again. They were still there. That's why I remember the last name and the dates, because I remember clearly. I mean, I was 18 years old. I remember what I was doing. And now that I'm 30 years old, I'm coming through here again, and I can't find them anywhere. I've been through here twice this year. Sometime between when I was a high school senior, when I was 18, and now that I'm 30, they remodeled the river. They dredged it all out. They put in new bike trails. They did everything. And walking through here, I can see evidence that there's been bulldozers and stuff, and I mean, it's all been cleared. The last time we were here a couple months ago, there were downed trees everywhere, places we couldn't pass, and I didn't come across any of that today. There was nothing in the way. The trail was completely clear all the way through. It looked like there'd been a bulldozer or something in here within the last 2 or 3 months, probably. The grass and stuff was just now starting to grow back over it, over the dirt. Yeah, so I'm thinking maybe when they redid the river and they dredged everything out, maybe they relocated the graves. I found a couple of big stones that I wasn't sure what they were. They're definitely man-made, but they weren't the gravestones that I was looking for. They were in the right places where those gravestones were. It wasn't them. So I'm thinking maybe they're relocated. Maybe they're just under the ground where they can't be seen anymore. But I mean, there's nothing through this section of the trail. It's not a very long piece of trail. There's nothing that they need to keep maintenance on. So I don't know why they, I mean, there is a big drain pipe back in there, but that's pretty soon, pretty early on. And the trail goes on way past that. So I don't know why they would keep this section maintained if there's nothing in here. So maybe they're still in here, maybe not. I can't find anything. I can't find the cross hanging from the tree. If it's a tree like this, the cross could actually be seen from the hiking trail, the bike trail, back in the old days before they repaved everything. And so it wasn't that far off from the main thing, but it was out here in the woods. I've never met anybody else that knew anything about them. I'm the only person other than the people that I brought with me or the guy that was with me when we first found it, nobody else knows anything about them. I can't find any information on it. I don't know what it is or what they were doing there. And I don't know if they've been moved. I can't find them. I've been out here twice. Spent a whole day out here with Jake a couple months ago in the middle of the summer. And now that it's winter, came back, figured it'd be a little bit easier to get through. And I've been out here for 3.5 hours now. I've walked the whole length of the stretch of that trail, the whole stretch of that trail, and nothing. There's nothing here. And I'm still looking around. I'm still, every time I see one of these trees similar to it, like this tree's got something, some rope or something hanging up in it. So every time I see something odd, I start looking around and maybe I'll find them. But there's, it doesn't look like there's anything here. That is weird. It's got some, there's rope hanging out of that tree. But it looks like it's been there so long, the tree's kind of growing around the rope. For whatever reason, the rope that was hanging up in that tree there didn't quite want to come out. Maybe it'll come out in the video instead of the picture, but in the picture it didn't want to come out. Yeah, you can kind of see it there. It looks like branches coming off of that. But that's the rope. It's a white rope, or a rope, maybe a power cord or something. But yeah, I just noticed that. And then when I was walking over here, having to look up in this tree, and there is what looks like a light fixture mounted to this tree here. And I'm looking around everywhere, because why would there be a light fixture in a tree in the middle of the woods? Actually looks like a shower head or something, but it's got an electrical box on it. And it's pointed down. There's no bulb in it, but it's pointed down. It is definitely a light fixture. I don't see any kind of power cords or anything going up there to it. But yeah, that's a light fixture mounted to the tree. And I don't know why there would be a light fixture in a tree in the middle of the woods, but I'm thinking I might be close. Don't see a cross anywhere, but that's been years and years and years. A cross probably wouldn't be there anymore. Why would they put a light fixture there? But I'm not within view of the bike trail. That's different. It's got to be here. Why else would they put a light fixture there? Why is that there? So anyway, after looking around for a while, I picked up this stick and started stabbing it into the ground to see if I could hit anything hard, any concrete or anything like that. And I was there. I did a pretty thorough search. I was there for probably about 20, 30 minutes in that one area for about 20 feet by 20 feet around that tree. Didn't find anything. I did find something. I found a piece of a pipe sticking up out of the ground right where that light fixture was pointing. And it looked like it might have been from a signpost or something. And it was cut off, like somebody cut off the sign and hammered it down so it wouldn't stab anybody. And I picked it up, I broke it out of the ground. It was only about 3 inches long. Right here I'm uncovering it. It's a piece of a pipe. It's probably about an inch in diameter, probably a signpost or something, like a no trespassing or keep out or something like that. But that's all I found. I don't know why there was a light fixture in that tree. My hands were all dirty. But once again, I didn't have any luck finding what I was looking for. So if you actually sat through this whole video so far, thanks. We're coming up on 25 minutes already for the video, which is probably my longest video so far that I've done. I don't think I've done anything quite this long. Especially one where I'm by myself. But yeah, it was an interesting day. Found a couple of cool things. But yeah, this was the highlight, was the light fixture in the tree. And I still have no idea what it was doing there. It was in the middle of nothing. No reason for it to be there.